Beautiful dancer.
Harper is a beautiful dancer. She works for the British Dance Company in Leeds. Her boss there is Nora Moore. One Monday morning, Harper arrives early. She sees Nora Moore at the coffee machine. "I've got some good news," says Nora Moore. "There is an envelope in her hand." "Really? What is it?" Harper asks. Nora Moore smiles. "Wait and see," she says. At 10 o'clock, the dancers are finishing their first class. Suddenly, Nora Moore walks into the room. "Can I have a word with you all, please?" she says. "What's this about?" asks Harper's friend, Emma. "I don't know," Harper answers. The music stops. "I have a letter here from Moscow," says Nora Moore. "The Russians want us to dance there next month." 6 weeks later, Harper is at Heathrow Airport in London. "You're going to have a very good time," says her father. "Of course she is, George," says Mrs. Fox. "Now, Harper, have you got everything? Ticket, passport, money?" Harper smiles. "Yes, Mum," she says.
Goodbye
to her parents. Then she sees Emma and Nora Moore. "Come on," says Emma. "It's time to go." On the plane, Harper and Emma talk about Moscow. They are both very happy. "I want to see everything," says Emma. The Kremlin, Red Square, the Bolshoi. "Me, too," says Harper, "and I want to meet lots of people." "Don't forget we're going there to work," says Nora Moore with a smile. In Moscow, a bus takes the dancers to their hotel. Harper and Emma's hotel room is on the second floor. Emma walks in and puts her bags down. "Great. There's a TV," she says and turns it on. A man is reading the news. She pushes another button. Now there's a pop video. "Look, Harper," she says. "Russian rock and roll." But Harper is not listening. She is looking out of the window. "Moscow," she thinks. "I'm in Moscow." Next day, the dancers work very hard. Their dance for the festival, Green Oceans, is new and very difficult. They start at 8 o'clock and finish at 6. Then, after dinner, they go to the Bolshoi Theater. "This is beautiful," says Harper. Emma sits down next to her. "It really is," she says. Then they watch the Russian dancers. They are all tall, strong, and very, very good. The day after, Harper and Emma finish at 3 o'clock. They go to a cafe and drink Russian tea. Then Emma looks at her map of Moscow. "Where do you want to go?" "The Pushkin Museum's near here," she says. "Okay, let's go there," says Harper. Then she looks at the people in the cafe. "I want to talk to them," she thinks. "But how? I can't speak Russian." In a street near the museum, there is a small market. "Oh, Emma, look," says Harper. She can see some red and yellow boxes on a table. Those are pretty. They are C music boxes, says a young man with glasses. You speak English, says Harper. The boy smiles. I'm studying it at university. My friend Nikolai and I only work here at weekends. Harper and Emma talk to the boys for a long time. Sasha, the one with glasses, speaks English very well. Nikolai only speaks a little. After 20 minutes, Sasha has an idea. Listen, he says. We're going to the country tomorrow for a week's holiday. Some friends are going with us. Do you want to come for the day? It's not very far. Next morning, Sasha and Nikolai arrive at the girls' hotel in their father's cars. There are three other people with them, Lara, Igor, and Sonia. They all drive to a lake near Moscow. Everyone is laughing and talking. At the lake, they have lunch. After that, Nikolai plays his guitar and sings Russian songs. Harper listens to him. There is a boat beside the lake. Late in the afternoon, Harper and Nikolai go out in it. Nikolai looks at Harper and smiles. Harper smiles, too. It's very beautiful here, she says. Nikolai looks into her eyes. Yes, he says. Beautiful. And you are beautiful, too. I think I... Harper. Emma shouts. Come on. It's time to go. Back in Moscow, there is a lot to do. All the dancers work very hard and have no free time. Harper is tired. Sad, too. She wants to see Nikolai again. But how, she thinks. Where? When? He's in the country and I'm here in Moscow. Then, the British dance company's big night arrives. Good luck, everyone, says Nora Moore. The evening goes very fast. Harper only thinks about one thing, green oceans. But then, 2 hours later, the music stops. She stands under a white light. Emma and all the other dancers are beside her. Everyone in the theater is throwing flowers. I think they like us, says Emma. There is a sad smile on Harper's face. Yes, she says. I think they do. 24 hours later, all the British dancers are at Moscow airport. Now I'm never going to see Nikolai again, thinks Harper. And I can't write to him. I don't know his ad. Then someone says her name. She turns. It's Nikolai. The plane's leaving, says Nora Moore. Harper looks at Nikolai. He gives her a parcel and walks away. On the plane, Harper sits next to Emma. Her eyes are wet. She opens the parcel. Oh, look, says Emma. It's one of those music boxes, the ones in the market. And there's a letter, too. What does it say? But Harper is too happy to speak. She looks at the letter. Can I come and see you in England? Oh, Nikolai, yes, she thinks. Yes, you can.
Level 1, Beginner. Basic Vocabulary. About 300 basic words. Congratulations on your dedication and good luck. Text read in American English. Level 1, Beginner. End of text by Easy English Abreu.